All right, so we finally made it to the Super Duper Mart, where prices are super. No, I'm going to rip off Cleveland, where prices are so low, they're ridiculous. So, as in past experiences, being in a Super Duper Mart, I can expect raiders. So we want to pull out our shotgun. I know I should use this on ghouls, but I want to see the effects on a raider's face. Is that too hard to ask from you guys? Can't I blast a raider in the face with the shotgun? Okay, there's a Protectron right there. So, there must be a terminal to activate that Protectron. Hopefully, I don't have to have a security badge for it to recognize me as a non-combatant. Okay. Well, at least that's better than drinking out of a toilet. Hey, yes, the water is still irradiated, but, you know, it's not toilet juice. And also, I have been studying. The most things that you think are useless, like that fan, you can actually scrap for pretty good things. Like, I believe you can pull out copper from the fan, you can, and screws, copper screws and steel out of fans. Also, if you're looking for springs and you're like, I don't know where to find a spring, I never knew where to get spring from. Now, clipboard, you know those useless clipboard you just overlook all the time? You can actually pull out springs and wood from the clipboard. So if you need springs for your project that you're doing, just go around and find a couple of clipboards. And you'll have some nice springs for you. And yes, even coffee mugs have uses. So coffee mug, of course, it's made out of ceramic. So if I need ceramic, which I don't know why I would need ceramic unless I'm building a bathroom, but maybe I'll find some uses for the ceramic. Back in the old days, I would just take coffee mugs, you know, because they were around. It's like, oh, there's coffee mugs in that store? Well, I'm going there first. Why do you need to have coffee mugs? Need to survive, we need food. Yeah, survival, whatever. But did you see that coffee mug that said number one dad? That's super rare. You don't see
men
those anymore. Number one dad? God. Okay, so this must be the Protectron's I can disengage his locks to open him up. Protectron controls. License technology only. Improper tampering with Protectron unit may lead to permanent injury. Status connected. One unit connected to this terminal. Okay. Please advise any personnel standing near charge bar to make way. Choose personality mode. Okay, subway steward, law enforcement, fire brigade, medical responder, construction worker. I'm gonna go with law enforcement. Give them that authority kind of voice. Parameters, personality parameter reset.
Powering up, Protectron on duty.
Oh, there was a safe? I didn't even know. Oh, was that first option for the save? Oh, I thought it was for the charging pod for the Protectron to unlock it. Huh, I guess maybe it was for the save. Whatever, win-win all around. Now let's see if he's going to attack me. Nah, he's too busy walking. He's like, this is the first time I have ever walked in 200 years, you gotta stretch them robo legs. Yeah, because robots need to stretch their robo legs. See, because the technology has advanced so far that even robots get cramps in their legs. Don't ask me how, they digest do, so that's why they gotta stretch their legs. I think he might have found a raider. I didn't hear any. Get him, boys! I don't think raiders do that anymore, but still. Get away from me!
Attention, citizens. You may now resume your normal activities.
You came in handy real quick. You came to actually protect me. Wow, you know, you live up to your name. I heard you shooting off in the distance, but you came in here, you came to help me in a matter of 30 seconds. Wow, you want to be my best friend? I'll dump dog meat in a minute. He doesn't even have lasers. Yeah, doesn't even have a metal jaw or metal teeth. He's okay. It seems like he can heal from any wound if you just let him stay there for a while, so I don't need to give him stim packs. And like I said before, I think he's just junky. He's a junky dog that smokes cigarettes, uses my stim packs. I figured out his secrets. He really don't need a stim pack. Just squeeze him. He's like a child that already has candy in his mouth, but when he goes to the store, he wants more candy just because. That's dog meat. Get to my... Oh, hold on. Just take these coffee mugs. Use that for some ceramics. Yeah, what a lovely couple. Oh, that guy... That girl over there was, Yeah, there's two girls and a guy. You may say, oh, they were just having a lovely lunch. That could have been his sister there. And they were having such a good time, but... The ghouls came and ate them. No, you're wrong. It was a love triangle. See, Susie, the one sitting by herself, she was having an affair with Josh, and his girlfriend found out, which her name is Meredith. And they were here at this diner here in the Super Duper Mart, and she was just about to confront both of them. But before she could confront the cheaters, you know, the feral ghouls came and slaughtered them all, because this place looks pretty well intact, and they're sitting in the booths in there. They're sitting in the booths at the restaurant, so the atomic holocaust thing grabbed them. They just got eaten by feral ghouls. Too bad for Sally there. She couldn't confront them. Just take some nice wine. This is the pharmacy. Okay, so Super Duper Mart really does have a lot of services. It has a pharmacy and it has a little restaurant, which will be shut down in a couple of months, because we all know that restaurants in big box stores like this usually don't last very long. I remember when I went to Walmart, they had a Blimpies inside the Walmart. I'm like, wow, I could get a sub while I'm in Walmart? Oh no! It just hit my level cap of picking up stuff. Boo! Boo! I should be able to carry infinite. Well, if you put some points in your strength, carry more stuff. Shut up, reasonable guy. I'm unreasonable. It doesn't work. I want to pick up infinity forever. So I guess I'll get rid of the laser musket because I already have one. Oh, what's going on? Music just happened. Oh, oh, oh! He's behind. Thank you. butt in your mouth. It didn't explode your head off. Alright, like I said, shotgun equals win. Fools cannot stand up. Shotguns. So, that begs the question, will there be a terrible shotgun in this game? Because you know, the terrible shotgun, the terrible shotgun, that thing was a ghoul murdering machine. Man, it's just a beautiful weapon. Of course, I believe you had to murder somebody to get it, but it was also worth it. I believe to find the terrible shotgun, you had to go into a cave, and in that cave there was a person you had to kill to obtain the terrible shotgun. I guess that's probably why they call it the terrible shotgun. Because it's not terrible in terms of firepower, terrible shotgun. Shut up, I'm making my own backstory for my own terrible shotgun. It's not from Mad Max. No, it's not. I deny it. But anyway, it's terrible in the way that you had to kill an innocent person to obtain that shotgun. That's why it has such a bad name. Such a bad name. I know there's gonna be more people around.
Hostile target identified.
Well, that's good for me because they're fighting for the time. This shotgun setup has such impact. There you go, Protectron. Ow! Dog alone. He's an idiot, but he's my idiot. So, the shotgun seems to be super effective. In bats, because you know I'm targeting their heads, and it's almost 100% death. But of course, these are just your normal feral ghouls. We haven't come across the glowing ones. Oh come on, this is unfair. Stop saying I'm getting too overcumbered. What do I need to get rid of now? Do I have too much clothing? I don't always need clothes. Damn these clothes. Always weighing me down when I could be looting stuff. Who cares if I'm naked? God! I wish I could just grow fur. I wish I could go back to the good old days when humans had fur all over the body. They wouldn't have to worry about clothing. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to actually limit myself. I will pick up like medical supplies and things that I know aren't heavy, like borax, stuff like that that's super lightweight. But don't be like, oh, you're just going to leave the stuff there? No, I'm not going to leave the stuff there. What I'm going to do is, after I'm done looking through the Super Duper Mart, I'm gonna go back to my house, dump my stuff in my box, and return. Because, you know, that's how we do. I don't trust that. They're faking it. I know they are. But just to make sure, I'm sure I'm gonna shoot a one shot. Hey, they might not be faking it. So, I thought they were attracted to noise, but I did fire that bullet and they didn't respond. So are they attracted to motion? They had to be attracted by something. Because you remember when I blew up that tractor trailer on top of that roof? They heard that. They all came swarming. So, I don't know the logic of the feral ghouls. Or yes. They might be legitimately dead. But I don't think the Protectron has come this way. Yeah, that's what I thought. Bro! That was a... Okay, so, like in Skyrim, there's going to be oil slash gasoline on the ground, and get the item. Okay, that is something. There better not be giant pots of boiling oil atop me where I can shoot. Hey, damn it! What a time to reload, huh? I get the perfect shot here. That needs a better sight. Yeah. I'm gonna go, once I get back to my house, I'm gonna see if I can upgrade the sight of the shotgun. Because I need it. I might be the terrible shot here. It just has this little tiny metal nub of a sight at the end of the barrel. I need to either make it bigger or change the color. Maybe to a nice bright orange. The green? Nah, the green. I don't like green science. I like orange. It's more. You can see it a lot better. It just makes it way. I should have some camo on this shotgun. Yeah, some orange wooded camo. You know. What do you mean I'm not hunting deer? Everybody's going to see my shotgun? You mean deer can't see orange? Oh, is that actually true? Yeah? No wonder. I'm like, oh, these guys are just making a fascist statement. That looks pretty cool, the orange with the wood. You know, try to make yourself stand out from the rest of the hunters.
I came back yesterday with Emma. Everyone's gone. Looks like they left in a hurry and had one hell of a fight. Feral corpses everywhere. Emma and I searched for anything they might tell us where they went. Only thing we found was Anthony. Must have been bad. They never would have left his body there. I sent Emma down to the loading dock to wait for me while I check on something. We won't stay long. I just want to get Anthony's body and... Wait! Arrows are back. Oh, fuck me.
You guys thought I was kidding about Josh and Sally and the other woman about having a love triangle. Now you know that I wasn't lying. See, I even found Josh's tape. Huh. See, sometimes my wacky stories that you don't believe turn out to be absolutely true. So, yeah. Take that! Okay, that was just complete coincidence. But, you know, it fitted pretty nicely with my story. I was not expecting that. Where does this lead me now?
Nice.
Oh, it leads me back into the main portion of the supermarket. Okay. Well, we got some experience points out of that anyway. Looks like this is the employee's office. Wow, this is a big office for employees. Wow, that's a big coffee machine. I thought it was like a sewing machine at first, but wow, they even got sewing machines in this game too? Oh, that's great. No, apparently they need giant machines to make one small cup of coffee. Hey, there's another cat picture. What's going on with all the cats? Sally? Oh, man. Am I nailing these names? Josh? Sally? Due to numerous customer complaints over the past couple of months, is it It is with a heavy heart to inform you all that we had to let Sally go. You may have also noticed that the new espresso machine we ordered has arrived. Until we can make room in the kitchen, the espresso machine has been installed on top of Sally's desk. Enjoy. Wow, they really do not like Sally. They got rid of her and they're using her desk as the espresso table. Espresso machine. Many have expressed concerns over the loud clicking noises the espresso machine makes when used. Unfortunately, we won't be able to move the machine for another 2 weeks. Turns out that the industrial mounts we ordered won't fit in our kitchen. We are currently in the process of hiring a contractor to come in and knock down a few walls to get the space required for the mounts. Please bear with us, management. Jesus Christ, I mean, I just saw your espresso machine. I mean, it's not that huge. I mean, it's big, but you don't need to be knocking walls down to put this thing in place. And noises, and you need industrial mounts to
now a word or several
to mount that thing. Wow, this sponsors. Thing must be rumbling
tired,
and shaking and
need to pick me up,
you know, just going all around. This don't worry, guys, I saw that safe on the wall, so you don't need to point it out. As I said before, I'm just a little too heavy right now. So I will be back, and if there's anything of significance, I will update you in the next video of what I found in that safe. I'm guessing there's just a couple bottle caps, maybe a gun. That's about it. But if I find a holotape or a letter, I will be sure to read it to you. So don't worry. Oh, that's an ugly carrot. I like my carrots babied. Yeah. Did you know that there's no such thing as baby carrots? They're just regular carrots shaved down to little nubs. I did not know that. Like, oh, they make baby carrots? That's pretty cool. That works so well. Combination of bats and shotguns. Ooh. But still, first person. I mean, not using bats, still pretty good. It's not bad. I should say you should use.
Hey,
get out of the bathroom. I was just bug me. Come on, don't stare at me.
How you doing, buddy?
Come on, I'm praising you here. Dude, move over. I'm trying to see what's in that turlet. So, somebody's been eating cereal while taking a dump. That's not weird. I do that all the time. Well, I'm not crazy, right? I be eating food on the toilet. What comes in must come out. I'm just saying, it's just... Yeah, that's gross. I just grossed myself out, and I just found out that I'm a gross human being. I mean, I've done that before. I'm in the kitchen. It's like, oh man, I gotta take a dump, but I don't want to stop eating my fruity pebbles. What am I going to do? First of all, is anybody in the house? No, there's nobody in the house. Oh my God, this is the greatest feeling in the world. Oh man, I didn't know sitting on the pooper and eating fruity pebbles will fit. I mean, eating fruity pebbles would feel oh so good. Why hasn't anybody thought of this before? I see the floor shining. Dog me, get over here. And I swear I heard somebody. I heard somebody. Dog meat, you're on fire. That's bad. Whatever. If you don't care, I don't care. Let me get my double barrel shotgun. Where is it? Oh, it's under short barrel, double barrel. I thought it was just barrel shotgun or double barrel shotgun, but it's shotgun, double barrel. George, you know what I mean? I was looking under B, but it was under S's. Industrial borax cleaner, yes. Now, you may say, what's the use of borax? Well, you can actually, if you're a chemist in this game, you can actually use the acid from the borax to create, well, you can use the acid from the borax to create chemicals or chems, whatever. If your character is a drug addict, you should be looking for borax because you can make more chems out of that. That's what I'm saying. Not that I want you to be a drug addict in this game, but we are in a post-apocalyptic wasteland, so if you want to be an addict, be my guest. But I will tell you one thing: if you try to rob me because you want to get chems, I will shoot you in your face. You know, remember, survival priority for me. Oh, and don't have anything on you that's really, really cool, because I'll really, really shoot you. I won't rob you. No, I won't rob you. That's beneath me. I'll pick your safe at your house, but I won't rob you. I will loot your corpse after I kill you, but I won't rob you. See, even I have morality. Yeah, it's not great, but morality nonetheless. You know, I won't punch a kid in its face for its lollipop. No, I would just go out in the desert and abandon it. See? And he gets to keep his lollipop. So remember, kids, don't follow me, because I'll abandon you in the desert. But you'll still keep your lollipop. There you go, see? It's kind of a win-win situation, if you know what I'm saying. Win for me that I got rid of a bratty kid, and win for you. I didn't take a caddy. I'm a terrible person. I know it, but whatever. It's not like I'm gonna go to Diamond City and like, where's the kids at? I need to abandon them really quick. Oh God, no. I hope no parents are watching this. Or if you are a parent, I hope you have a sense of humor. Because I kind of don't mean this stuff, and I kind of do mean this stuff. Kind of, maybe. Well, not really. Whatever, I'll just say you judge. You judge. You think I'm a dirtball? Go right ahead. I'm just saying, I need to survive here. Alright. Is that it? I think I've looked everywhere here in the Super Duper Mart. Wow. A storm has rolled in while I was digging through the Super Duper Mart. And that terminal over there on the wall seems like it opens some doors. Alright. So what I will do is come back, hit clean Super Duper Mart, and we'll continue from